malaria is an organism, small organism, so small it's called a protozoa, it's single cell, and it infects people, especially in the tropical areas such as Africa, which is a major place where malaria exists, but it's also in Asia and Latin America.
A little less than 500,000 children die every year in Africa alone of malaria. So there's a tremendous burden. For many diseases, measles for example, you get exposed to measles once, and if you survive, then you're forever, throughout your life, immune to measles. Malaria is a disease that children will have in endemic areas in Africa, 50, 60 infectious bites a year from a mosquito, and not become immune until they're in their early adolescence, early teens.
Plasmodium parasite is a really complex organism. There are over 5,400 genes. Genes mostly regulate how parasite can proliferate within these different environmental conditions inside different cells, and then how it can hide from the immune system. A transcription factor family is what we worked on. We actually changed only one nucleotide. We showed that 46 genes are differentially influenced by this change. So we first infected a group of mice with the wild type parasite, the normal parasite, and then with our mutant parasite. And first we saw a difference in the immune response by looking at the levels of antibodies and some protective soluble mediators, which we call as cytokines. With this new ability that the immune system can detect it, then the mutant parasite was completely destroyed and cleared, but the original one mounted a full-blown disease.
He made a virulent parasite less virulent, because the gene that he changed made the parasite able to induce an immune response in the mouse model.
Changing a transcription factor can change a whole system of different genes. So actually it still warrants further investigation, because some of them may be more important than the others, and finding this will put us closer to developing therapeutics or vaccines against malaria.